Okay. So, thank you, Christian, for improving your comments, ano? So, it's a lot readable now na yung comments mo ay smaller bits na. And it's not really overwhelming na binabagsakan ka ng isang ganun ka haba na paragraph. So, I love this one. And also, the topic is really interesting as well. This is something that I would love to address kasi you are asking this, you are asking to debunk me na may ganong what the fuck is this? Okay, may yeah, may ganong ano na stop sa Bible. Sorry, nadidistract talaga ako sa shape ng buhok ko. Okay. So yun. The question is this. I'm sorry if the intro took so long. So, nalaman ng mga scientists na 90% ng mga nadiskubre na bagay sa universe ay gawa sa dark matter. Okay, nalaman ng mga scientists na malaking porsyento daw sa I'm not sure if it's 98% ah. But malaking porsyento daw sa universe is dark, gawa sa dark matter. And then, sabi niya dito, nauna nang nasabi ito ng Bible. Mateo 25:30 and Judas 1:13. I'm not familiar with the Bible, ano, but let's go ahead and read Mateo 25:30. Mateo 25:30. Hey. So, itapon ninyo sa kadiliman sa labas ang walang silbing taong iyan. Dooy mananangi siya at magngangalit ang kanyang mga ngipin. Okay, that's Tagalog. Baka meron sa English, ano? Matthew 25:30. Baka kulang yung ano mo, yung chapter 25:30 mo. Baka mas marami pa palang verses kailangang basahin. So, ito yung English. Now then, take the talent from him and give it to the one with 10. For to everyone who has, more will be given and he will grow rich. But from the one who has not, even what he has will be taken away. And throw this useless servant into the darkness outside. There will be wailing and grinding of teeth. So I'm not sure if you made a mistake in pasting a Bible verse kasi I don't see anything that's related to dark matter at all, or sinabi ng Bible na gawa sa dark matter ang mundo or ang universe. So let's go ahead and go to Judas 1:13. Sila'y mga alon sa dagat na ang bula ay ang kanilang mga gawang kahiyahiya, mga ligaw na bituin na nakalaan sa kadiliman magpakailanman. Okay, merong word na kadiliman, mayroong word na bituin. I think it's talking something, but I'm sure it's not talking about dark matter. Pero even if it was able to predict, like literally talk about the dark matter in a way that's using languages ng sinauna, kasi marami tayong mga recent lang na discover na mga words, 'di ba, mga scientific terms, kasi nag-i-improve yung scientific learnings natin. So obviously the languages we use in the past, especially nung time na sinulat ng Bible, yung Bible, limitado. So, I don't think it's because of limited languages kaya ganoon yung pagka-describe nila sa dark matter. I don't know. It has nothing to do with the limited understanding or limited language. It's just that it's not talking about the dark matter. It's not predicting that dark matter exists. It's so funny that you gave these verses kasi I was expecting na baka meron talagang kahit konti man lang na mga scientific mumbo jumbo na nakamix just for us to move forward with the conversation, but this is really nothing and it's really laughable and I find it funny. I can give you examples, ano, that are way better. That sounds way more scientific, siguro, if I encounter them. But at the end of the day, we people, the general public, don't get, ano, impressed if we find something in a book na somehow nauna niyang na-predict ang isang scientific discovery. It's not, it's a common thing. It's a common thing if you go, if you open any kind of book 1,000 years ago, you will see something that, lalo na kung malawak yung imagination mo, you will see something na it will somehow, it can somehow predict the future. Kaya nga yun yung nangyari kay Nostradamus, di ba? Na-discover yung book niya, at ininterpret siya ng mga tao, kaya ang daming tumugma daw ng mga pangyayari dito sa present, ang na-predict na daw ni Nostradamus. It's not him having a power or something na prophetic na power. It's just us being so imaginative and being so, kanang, ano tawag doon? Gullible. Like, kaya nating i-interpret ng isang bagay na wala namang, kagaya ng shiner mo, itong Mateo 25 and Judas 1:13. It has nothing in it that sounds like even scientific. And even if meron talagang legit, ano, I would need it to explain stuff, not just predict stuff, in order for me to believe na it was able to know something in advance. Diba? Kasi, for example, let's say, na-discover, diba, recent na, when was gravity discovered? So, 1687 by Isaac Newton. 1687. That's almost 400 years ago. 300 plus years ago. Let's say, mayroon tayong na-discover na book on the year, ano, 687. 1,000 years before na-discover ni Newton. Meron tayong na-discover na book that talks about gravity and it describes gravity. I wouldn't be impressed. I mean, I bet Isaac Newton already read books na nag-discover about a stuff pero hindi palang klaro yung definition nila what, ano is, what gravity is. Baka by their interpretation, it's a force. Baka in their interpretation, it's a ghost or it's a created by God, but there is gravity. So, that's not very interesting kasi we have that, we always have that. We always have people who learns about something pero yung version niya ng knowledge is limited. It's not yet the accepted na version. So, if someone discovered gravity on the year 687, 1,000 years before Isaac Newton, and he talks about it like, ano, like how Isaac Newton is talking about it in the year 1687, that would be really interesting. Kasi may nauna na pala kay Isaac Newton, and then yung theory pala niya is way more accurate than Isaac Newton. Yung law of gravity pala niya is way more, ano, way more descriptive and it's way more helpful to the scientists that are working on it now or using it now as an application. So wala eh, wala. Walang anything na konkreto, na very solid na pagka-discuss ng Bible about scientific discoveries that we know now. It's just talking in a poetic way. It's just talking, I mean, this verse na Mateo 25 is talking about a person na itapon mo. Parang may galit siya sa isang I don't fucking know. But it's not talking about the dark matter, man. I mean, this is very funny. Yun yung frustration ko. If your book is talking about science, that would be really great. Kasi no need na for our scientists to discover things on their own, to test things on their own, to make some experimentations. Hindi na nila kailangan, hindi na nilang magtrabaho ng ilang years, ng 50 years to 20 years to work on something na alam naman pala ng Bible years back. Hindi ganun yung nangyari. Hindi alam ng Bible. Kasi kung alam nila, the scientists would easily use them and use it as a tool to do some experimentation. But no, hindi ganoon yung science. Ang science kasi is demonstration, proving things that are true, proving things that are false, making some predictions, making sure those predictions are in line, are nagtutugma. Yun yung science eh. Let me give you an example. Sorry, hindi talaga ako very smart sa science, but what can you give me an example of scientific method? Ah, yun yung the theory of gravity.
I'm not an expert.
Yung theory of evolution in Charles Darwin, it has kuan, di ba? Observations.
Uh-oh.
Okay. Charles Darwin, sa paggawa niya ng theory of evolution, is he used his senses to observe things. Na-observe niya, hala, bakit ang daming species? Bakit may isang bird na klase-klase yung beak, yung laki ng beak? Bakit may maliliit, may malalaki, pero magkapare-pareho lang yung kulay? Bakit yung pareho lang yung kulay ng birds, hindi pwedeng mag-procreate? Bakit may mga species ng dogs na hindi pwedeng mag-procreate? Bakit yung species ng horse, bakit ang result niya is donkey? Bakit yung donkey hindi na makaprocreate? Nag-observe siya and wala siyang idea how to answer that. Why are things this way? Bakit ang daming species? May sagot ang religion, may sagot ang church. God created stuff. And that's so easy. I don't have to demonstrate it. I just have to read the Bible and have to take the word from our priests and from our preachers. And that's it. I'm not gonna ask any more questions. But no, Darwin took it a step further and studied things, made observations, track them down, read some books, read other people's research, and bumuo siya ng theory. Gumawa siya ng story. Gumawa siya ng explanation why things are this way. So, may mga experimentations ang ginawa. May nilagay siya yung finches na bird. If you read his book, it was really interesting. So, parang ganun yung mga na-discover niya. Even sa plants, may mga different kinds of species din sa plants na nangyayari. So, that's what he did. And then, sa theory niya, he then made some predictions. He then made some statements that he can then be proven false. You can prove him false. If you can find meron din nakasulat sa libro niya eh. If you can find some fossils na ganito yung, like for example, sabi niya, sa theory of evolution niya, una yung mga amphibians, then land animals came. So parang may transition from water, fishes, and then came the amphibians, yung mga animals na can live both on water and land, then came the land animals. So in his theory, I'm just not sure, huh? you can try and discover it yourself, but in his theory, if you can find a fossil daw ng land animal that's way older than the fish, meaning nag-exist na pala ang mga land animals way before the water animals, then mapuproven false mo yung yung theory niya na we came from water and then moved to land. Diba? So, yun yung mga predictions niya. And other interesting stuff that his theory of evolution was able to help other scientists develop vaccines, develop medicine, kasi we understand that viruses evolve, bacteria evolve, kaya di gumagana itong antibacterial na to kasi nag-e-evolve ang mga and that's because of the theory of evolution. That's now we understand about germ theory because of the theory of evolution. Ang daming applications na ginagamit natin today because of, because of the other stuff like physics and the theory of tawag dito. Quantum mechanics, it enabled us to develop computers, and you're using it now, and you are debunking them, you are making fun of scientists while you're using their hard work, their the fruit of their labor. So I mean, you'd go back at me and say na lahat naman yan gawa yan lahat ng Diyos. Another difference, the difference is I can prove to you that scientists made the internet, people made the smartphones. You can't prove your God made anything. You can't prove, and that's the difference. You can say that everything is created by God, but at the end of the day you can't prove it. I can't prove that the laptop is made by human beings and robots and not made by giraffes. That's the difference. You can say, I can say too, I can say stuff too, but I can prove the stuff that I say. You fucking can't. So what else? Yun. That's how science works. That's how I learned to appreciate science after I understood the scientific method. Hindi pala siya ganun na, sinulat niya to, nasulat ito ng isang tao 50,000 years ago, grabe, hindi pa na-invento yung gamot na yun, pero naisulat na pala niya. That's not very convincing. A lot of people have a lot of weird ideas on their head, and a lot of people discover things every day. The only difference is people write theories, and those theories, pinapasa nila sa mga taong credentialed din to be peer-reviewed. Ipapareview yung gawa nila. Kasi if they are not peer-reviewed, like yung mga gamot natin, alternative medicine, that's the reason why you can say na itong compact alien, tawag doon? Tungkat ali, ano yan?
Tungkat ali.
That's the reason why people can produce medicines and say that they can heal cancer, stage 4 cancer, because you are allowed to. I mean, there's no, parang walang strict na law to really, safeguard what is true and what is fake. So, a lot of people can fake credentials, but there are a few that were able to pass the criticisms of the credentialed public, the credentialed few. So yun yung napakaganda, the beauty of scientific theories, kasi tinrabaho siya ng ilang years. May mga taong nag-check nito and fina-check siya and dininay, pina-revise. Kaya if you are a high school student or college, dumaan ka sa research, right? Meron kayong research na subject. And ilang beses kang pina-revise ng teacher mo kasi mali yung mga data mo. That's how science, that's how a scientific theory is. The high school si research that we have is just the simulation lang para for you to be able to understand na ganito pala, to appreciate the hard work that people have done to produce a theory. Pero it's not comparable pa nga din eh. It's not comparable. Iba pa din yung ang scrutiny na dinadaan ng mga scientific theories. So yun, don't come to me and show me verses, because I can come to you and open the Harry Potter book, even if it's fiction. I can find anything in there that will say na, "Loh, grabe ito. Itong green na stuff na lumalabas sa stick, na predict niya yung yung flashlight." Diba? I can be very creative and make stories up para gumawa ng kwento and para maka-confirm ito sa mga biases ko. Go ahead. I challenge you. You can open any books in the past and discover stuff and interpret stuff na somehow na-discover niya itong mga scientific na discoveries na we were able to discover today. So, yun.